You're late.
It's a little late, yes. Our friend had to change a tire.
Who's that? Where are you?
You'll see. I'm not coming, Gregory.
Why not?
Shouldn't the question be why? You may have forgotten it, but I have not been able to wash the bad taste out of my mouth since we talked last. It seemed you forgot that I've always been a man of my word, Gregory, and when I say I'll pay an amount, I'll pay that amount. We gave you the chance to negotiate the deal beforehand, and...
I had no idea.
I have not finished talking. You don't get to interrupt me. You don't get to hop on your high horse and pretend that you're greater than me. And, most importantly, you don't have the right to try and uproot this entire organization. You're a bomb maker and a contracted mercenary. You don't have a job unless I say so. When I said I'd figure something out, I didn't mean I'd be having a cup of Earl Grey tea sitting in the chair opposite yours next to the window with your fancy pillows with patterns of houses and...
How do you know all this?
Yes, that is the million-dollar question, isn't it? Well, bad news for you is that you're not the only assassin in this godforsaken country. Our guy is very good. That's how I know. They rang me just before I rang you.
Who is this guy?
You'll see. Good luck. You'll need it if you ever want to renew a contract again.
Thank you. this far. You got about a minute left, buddy.
Chantel?
It's done.
That git wasn't going to last long, huh?
He was smart, but predictably so.
What did you do?
It was pretty obvious he was trying to lure me into the house. I could, like, hear a bomb underneath. Basement. He wanted to kill me cleanly, to make it look almost accidental.
And so?
So I returned the favour. I purposely misfired at him and trapped him in the house myself. Pretty funny, actually. Would have been kind of humiliating for him too, but...
But what?
Well, he's dead, isn't he?
Oh, of course.
So what now?
As we close the story of Gregory, we open the story of Jimmy.